Greetings to all students and viewers. This is our fifth lecture from the first unit of Engineering Geology, and today's topic is volcanoes. So let's start with the volcanoes. So these are the points to be discussed in this lecture, that is, what is volcano, what are the terminologies associated with the volcanoes, volcanic products, pyroclastic materials, type of volcano, classification of volcanoes, and the surface lava flows. So, what is the meaning of volcano? So, the name of volcano is given after a small island near Sicily, which was named by the ancient Romans. And the volcano meaning is Vulcan, derived from Vulcan, which means the Roman gods of fire. And the volcano is a vent or an opening through which the molten magma or the lava comes out. This is called a volcano, which contain hot gases, superheated steam and pyroclast material and stone, which are thrown up through the volcanic eruption. And if you're talking about the magma and lava, so the liquid rock which is inside a volcano are called magma, and when this is magma comes out on the earth's surface, it becomes lava. So this is the basic difference between magma and lava. The rock material or the molten material which is present inside the volcano, this is called magma, and when this magma comes out on the earth surface, it becomes lava. And if we talking about the temperature, so the fresh lava has temperature for from 700 degrees Celsius to 1200 degrees Celsius. The most dangerous and volcanic eruption recorded is the eruption of Mount Helens in Washington. And the tallest volcano in the world is the Hoyos del Salado in Chile. And if we're talking about the largest, world largest volcano is the Mauna Loa in Hawaii. So this is the tallest volcano, and largest volcano is Mauna Loa in Hawaii. Now, what are the terminologies associated with the volcanoes? So this is a cross section of a volcano which gives the features about the volcanoes. So this is a magma chamber. What is magma chamber? We have discussed in the internal structure of the earth lecture. Magma chamber, which is present in the asthenosphere, which contain include a magma in a molten state. So this is a magma chamber, and it spread through the fractures or a joints. So this is magma. This is a pipe-like structure which is called vent, through which the magma comes out. This is a mouth of the volcano which is called crater. Crater is nothing but the mouth of the volcano. And this cone-like structure is called a volcanic cone or cone, where the magma is spread out. This is lava flow, and this is a cloud of volcanic ashes, and which contain the volcanic bombs and pyroclastic materials, gases, solid material and liquid material. And these layering arrangement is called ash layers. So all these features are the terminologies of the volcanoes. So now, volcanic products. So there are three volcanic products, that is solid, liquid and gas. We can see one by one. The solid material of different sizes is ejected out of volcano during eruption. They are called pyroclastic materials. So these material of varying size and grades are known differently based on their size and shape. For example, volcanic bombs, lapilles, cinder, volcanic ash and volcanic dust. These all are solid material which is called pyroclastic material. And if we talking about the liquid, so the liquid is the most important product of volcanic eruption, which is in the form of molten state. And the average temperature of magma ranges between 1000 degrees Celsius to 12,000 degrees Celsius. And we have all seen the basic difference between what is magma and what is lava. So the rock material which is present below or inside the volcano, it is called magma. And when these material comes out on the earth surface, it becomes lava or it is called lava. And if you're talking about the gases, then the water vapors form one of the most important part or a consists of total volcanic gases. These water vapors may comes from the original magma or due to boiling of underground water in the volcanic area. And what are the composition of the volcanic gases? So the example which contain water, that is in 70%, carbon dioxide, that is in 15%, and nitrogen, that is 5%. And along with these all gases, there are other remaining gases which are sulfur dioxide, hydrogen sulfide, carbon monoxide, hydrogen, hydrochloric acid, and methane, chlorine, and argon. All these gases are also present along with the water, carbon dioxide, and nitrogen. So these are the basic volcanic products. These are erupt during the eruption of the volcanoes. So let's see what is the pyroclastic materials. So pyroclast means hot or broken fragments. And if we accumulate or assemble these pyroclasts, it becomes tephra. And depending on the size of tephra, it's classified as bombs, blocks, lapilles, or ash. So what are blocks? Blocks are the angular fragments that were solid when ejected. Whereas bombs, which have an aerodynamic shape which indicating they were liquid when they were ejected. So on the basis of their ejection, the blocks are solid. And if you're talking about the bombs, they have aerodynamic shape which is indicating that they are in liquid state when they were ejected during the eruption of volcano. And when these bombs and lapilli consist mostly of gases, it becomes a vesicular rock. And this is called a pumice. Pumice is a vesicular rock fragment which contain a highly viscous density because of the low viscous density, because of the low density. So this is called pumice, which contain vesicles in it. And that rock fragments by accumulation and cementation of tephra are called pyroclastic rock or tuff. It is also called as tuff. So this is a table which give the information about the size of the material. This is pyroclastic material, this is the unconsolidated material, that is tephra, and this is the size in mm. So if we talking about the tephra, that is bombs and blocks, which is more than 64 mm, whereas the pyroclastic material, that is agglomerate, is also a pyroclastic rock. It is also in size is 64 mm, more than 64 mm. And then lapilli tuff is a tephra unconsolidated material. The size of lapilli tuff is 2 to 64 mm. And in pyroclastic material, that is lapilli is also in same size. And if we talking about the ash, so it is less than 2 mm. So this is called a pyroclastic material. So pyroclast is hot broken fragments, and when it assemblages, it gives a tephra. Tephra is of three types on the basis of their size, that is blocks, bombs, lapilles. So blocks are the angular fragments that they were solid when ejected, and bombs are the aerodynamic shape indicating they were liquid when they ejected. And these bombs and lapillaries that consist mostly of gases or bubbles, which give the vesicular structure to that particular rock, which is called as pumice. And if the rock fragment by accumulation and cementation of tephra, which becomes the pyroclastic rock or the tuff. So this is a pyroclastic material. This is a solid volcanic product. Now this is a type of volcano, that is stratovolcano, shield volcano and lava dome. So if you're talking about the stratovolcano, so stratovolcano, these are steep sided volcanic cones which are built up of fragmentary material and mostly cinders, as we have discussed the cinders. Such ones are usually very symmetrical and circular in shape. The crater of this volcano is in circular shape, and they often occur as a parasitic or larval volcano. So the stratovolcano is a larger volcano, and it gives a steep sided volcano. It is like a layering arrangement because of the eruption of the magma, arrangement of the magma. And it gives, so that on the basis of the layering arrangement, so on the basis of these, it gives a name of stratovolcano, because strata means the layers. Now what is the shield volcano? So the shield volcano are composed mainly of solidified lava flows. They are much flatter than the stratovolcano. They are flatter because of the composition of the magma or the eruption of the magma. They have a slope of a few degree at their flanks and nearly 10 degree. Because it's flatter, so it gives only 10 degree slope. They derive their name from the shape of the cones, which is more or less like a shield. So on the basis of their formation on their structure, it gives the name shield volcano, because of these magma spread all around the volcanic cone. So if we take a picture from the satellite, it gives a shield like structure. So on the basis of these, it gives a name shield volcano. And the lava dome. So the lava dome is nothing but the as similar as the shield volcano because of the magma. So in this magma, in this volcano, the arrangement of the magma is in the dome like structure, and it is also a steep slope. And the magma which comes on the earth's surface becomes lava, and then lava is spread all around the volcanic mouth and gives a dome like structure. So on the basis of the structure, it gives the name lava dome. So this is a stratovolcano, this is shield volcano, and this is lava dome volcano. Three basic types of volcanoes. Now we will see the classification of the volcanoes. So the classification of volcano, it's divided into three basic type or group. That is, the first is the classification of volcano on the basis of their eruption, and the second is on the basis of their fissure eruption or quiet type of eruption, and the third is the classification of volcano on their periodicity. So we will see first the mode of eruption. So on the basis of the mode of eruption, the classification of volcano is divided into five class. The first is Hawaiian type volcano, second is Strombolian type volcano, third is Vulcanian, fourth Vesuvius, and the fifth one is Pelinian type of volcano. So what is Hawaiian type of volcano? So in the Hawaiian type eruption, the mobile lava or the basaltic lava composition is discharged, which is relatively quiet. So the lava flows out from lava pools and occupies a crater or from the fissures. So sometimes the fountains of lava are formed due to rapid emission of the gases. So these type of eruption is characteristics of Hawaiian volcanoes. And as we have discussed, the Hawaiian volcano, particularly Mauna Loa. So this is a quiet type of eruption, and the example of the Hawaiian type of volcano is Mauna Loa volcano. So, and what is the Strombolian type volcano? So if you're talking about the Strombolian type of volcano, so in the Strombolian type of volcano, the viscous lava erupt with moderate explosion. So on the basis of these, it thrown out all the material thrown out to form a bombs or lumps of scoria. Scoria is also a solid particle or material of solid volcanic products. And Stromboli volcano is also erupt the dangerous gases through the eruption of the volcano. And Vulcanian type of volcano. So Vulcanian type of volcano is more violent than the Strombolian type of volcano. In the viscous lava solidifies quickly and causing severe explosion. This result in the ejection of solid rock fragments of all sizes, including ash, dust, bombs, blocks, lapilies, and many more. And in these eruption, dark clouds of dust are usually seen. So this is the more violent type of volcano as compared to Strombolian and Hawaiian. And if you're talking about the Vesuvius, so in this case the lava highly charged with gases and erupt with extreme violence, and large amount of gases and dust are thrown up into the air, which form a cauliflower like cloud at a great height. So this is a most violent as compared to Vulcanian. Vulcanian is more violent than the Strombolian, and Vesuvius is more violent than the Vulcanian. Now if you're talking about the Pelinian type of volcano, so it is the most violent type of volcano eruption, in which a blast of the gases rises to a great height. So as we have seen, the Hawaiian type is a quiet type, little bit explosion in it. And if you're talking about Strombolian, there are small explosion. And if you're talking about the Vulcanian, it is a more violent. Vesuvius is more violent than the Vulcanian. And then if you're talking about the Pelinian, then Pelinian is more violent than the Vesuvius. So on the basis of the mode of eruption, these are the volcanoes type. Now we will see the classification of the volcano on the basis of fissure eruption or the quiet type of eruption. So if we're talking about the lava flood and lava flow, so in this way the eruption of the volcano happen through the fissure or joint and cracks, due to which all the lava comes out on the earth's surface and spread all around the volcano mouth and volcano land surface, and it looks like a lava flood. So on the basis of the eruption, it gives the name lava flood or lava flow. And if we're talking about the mud flow is also a quiet type of eruption. In this eruption, the magma comes out and the lava is spread all around the earth in a small patches because of the less viscosity. विस्कोसिटी और विस्कस मैग्मा इज नथिंग बट द टर्म इज यूज विस्कस विच मीन्स द रेजिस्टेंट टू फ्लो ऑफ अ लावा. सो ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ विस्कोसिटी द मैग्मा और लावा इट रेजिस्ट टू फ्लो ऑल अराउंड द वॉल्केनो एंड इन द मड फ्लो द लावा स्प्रेड इन अ पैचेस. सो इन दिस वे इट गिव्स अ मड लाइक स्ट्रक्चर. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड मड फ्लो लावा सॉरी वॉल्केनो मड फ्लो वॉल्केनो. सो ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ फिशर इरप्शन और क्वाइट टाइप इरप्शन देर आर टू बेसिक टाइप डेट इज लावा फ्लड एंड मड फ्लो. नाउ इफ यू टॉकिंग अबाउट द पेरियोडिसिटी so on the basis of the periodicity of the volcano is divided into three type, that is active volcano, dormant volcano and extinct volcano. The first is active volcano. So if you're talking about the active volcano, so the active volcano is one which erupt very often. They mostly occur at the crustal plate boundaries where the crustal movement is happening. And depending on the variation in the frequency of their activity, volcanoes erupt in the crustal boundaries. The volcanoes that occur along a great arc around the Pacific Ocean or from the Chile to East Indies. And this is called a active volcano. And if we're talking about the dormant volcano, so the volcano which show eruption after long intervals of time, this is called a dormant volcano. So during the dormant period, they appear quite inactive. The active volcano is active because it erupts mostly occur at a crustal plate boundary, and where we talking about the dormant volcano. Then the dormant volcano is erupt after a very long time interval. So on the basis of this, it is called dormant volcano. And during the dormant period, they appear quite inactive. And the extinct volcano, it gives the extinction or the ended period. An ancient volcano which has not shown any volcanic activity since a very long time in the geological history. So this is a very give a extinct volcano. This is called extinct volcano which never erupt or give or when give volcanic activity since a very long time in the past years. So this is called a extinct volcano. So on the basis of their periodicity, the volcano divide into three, that is active, dormant and extinct. Active volcano is actively charged because of magma. It mostly occur in the crustal plate boundary, that is in the Pacific Ocean, which is also called as ring of fire. And if we talking about the dormant volcano is erupt after a very long time period or interval of a very long gap. So this is called dormant volcano, and whereas the extinct volcano is which nothing show any volcanic activity since a very long time in the geological history or the past history of the earth. So this is called extinct volcano. So these are images of the volcanoes. This is Hawaiian type volcano. This is a Vesuvius. This is Strombolian. This is Vulcanian. This is lava flow and lava flood. We can see in the Hawaiian type of volcano, there is a little bit of explosion. This is Vesuvius type of volcano, which gives a sharp mouth or crater. This is Strombolian type of volcano, which gives a cauliflower structure of dust cloud or gas cloud. It is a Vulcanian type of structure volcano, which also give a cauliflower structure. It is most violent volcano as compared to this strombolian type of volcano. And these image which show the lava flows are flood lava. This is the image of fumaroles which we will see in the next slide. So now, what are the phenomena associated with the volcano? So there are three basic phenomena which are associated with the volcano, that is hot spring, geysers and fumaroles. We have seen or we have read about these geysers and fumaroles. Now see one by one. So what is hot spring? So the hot spring are commonly found or associated with volcanic activity of recent date. So because of the volcanic activity, the hot spring is associated, and due to which they all include the steam, hot steam. And the surface water which penetrate the ground may be heated either by contact with hot rock or by the gaseous formation from the volcanic rock. So it gives a rise to hot spring or hot gases stream. So this is a hot spring. And if you're talking about the geysers, so this is the example of geyser. It is the image from the Yellowstone Park of USA. This geyser is present in USA in the Yellowstone Park. So geyser are the fountain of hot water ejected periodically are called geysers. So geyser often rise to height of 30 to 60 meters. After the jet of water ceases, a column of steam rushes out, usually with a thundering roar. So it gives a thundering roar. One of the best known geyser areas in the world is the world largest geyser, which is present in the Yellowstone National Park, which is in USA. And geyser are also found in the other parts of the world, including New Zealand, Iceland. And if you're talking about the deposition, so the siliceous deposit form around the geyser, which is also known as geyserite. So all over the geyser, siliceous material is accumulated all around the geyser, which is called a geyserite. And if you're talking about the fumaroles is nothing but also type of a geyser, which gives the steam and hot gases, which discharge the steam and hot gases from the volcanic vent. So it is called a fumaroles, and the fumaroles emitting mainly sulfur gases. So it contain the sulfur dioxide and gives the sulfur gases. And if we're talking about the deposition of the fumaroles, so the fumaroles often deposit solid materials in the mineral matter, that is volcanic sublimates, which is also called as volcanic sublimate, near the vent of the fumaroles or near the mouth of the fumaroles, and deposit of the native sulfur and many more sulfur dioxide and native sulfur are accumulated through the fumaroles all around the vent of the fumaroles. So this is a hot spring, this is geyser, and this is fumaroles. So hot spring is the activity which is associated near the volcano or the upper the volcano, which gives the hot water with the hot steam. And if you're talking about the geyser is like a fountain which give a hot water shower, or which ejected a hot water through the geyser. And the height of the these rise of hot water is 30 to 60 meter. And fumaroles, it give is also like a geyser, but it contain the steam and hot gases, and it gives a sulfur gases. And the material which deposited around the fumaroles is a native sulfur, and the material which deposited around the geyser is a geyserite. Now, surface lava flows. So, on the basis of the magma composition, there are three basic surface lava flows. The first is blocky lavas, ropey lavas, and pillow lavas. So, what are the blocky lavas? So, blocky lavas is because of their high silica content, they are usually very viscous. So, on the basis of silica percentage, blocky lava is highly viscous. Viscosity we have discussed. Viscosity is the resistance of flow of lava. So, on the basis of silica percentage, which contained by the magma, so on the basis of the silica contained, they are usually viscous and their movement is very slow. Such slow moving lava generally have a rough and slinker like surface. So on the basis of the structure, it gives the name blocky lavas. And ropey lavas, when a lava flows, has a smooth but twisted surface. So this is called a ropey lava. Such surface is commonly formed on a fast flowing fluid lava of basaltic composition. So on the basis of silica composition, this has a high silica percentage as compared to the blocky lava. And when the lava starts solidify, a plastic skin is formed on its surface. The plastic skin is dragged into wrinkles and still molten lava continues to advance and beneath it and solidified it. So this is a ropey lava, this is in basaltic in nature and this is silicic in nature. So on the basis of the viscosity, it is slow moving lava and this is a fast moving lava and it gives a wrinkle like structure and twisted structure. So this is called ropey lava and this is blocky lava. And if we talking about the pillow lavas, so pillow lavas of basaltic composition and flows over a sea floor. This is a volcanic eruption under the sea floor. So if it solidify with a surface which exhibit the pillow-like structure, and such lava, the diameter of these pillow-like structure vary from a few centimeter to a few meter. The lava having very such surface is called pillow-like structure or a pillow lava. So these pillow are mostly are commonly glassy outside and finely crystalline inside. So it looks like glassy outside and it's finely crystalline material inside. So this is a pillow lava. So on the basis of surface lava flows, there are three basic type of lava flows, that is blocky lava, ropey lava and pillow lava. So blocky lava is on the basis of the silica percentage, it is less viscous. This is as compared to ropey lava. Ropey lava is highly viscous and this is a pillow lava. These two lavas are spread on the earth surface, or the eruption happen on the earth surface, and only the pillow lava is erupt in the sea floor or on the sea floor. So this is a pillow lava. So now summary. So we have seen the volcano. So volcano, what is volcano? Volcano is a vent or a fissure in the earth surface, earth crust, through which the hot lava or molten material or gases comes out. And these volcanic eruption may be either explosive or quiet type of volcano. And the basic difference, that is magma and lava. So the rock, liquid rock inside a volcano are called magma. And when this magma comes out on the earth surface, it becomes lava. And if you're talking about the temperature, so the temperature of lava is 700 degrees Celsius to 1200 degrees Celsius. And द टॉलेस्ट वॉल्केनो इन द वर्ल्ड इज द ओजोस डेल सेलेडो इन चिले एंड द लार्जेस्ट वॉल्केनो इन द मोआना लोआ इन हवाई. And then terminology, so we have discussed about the terminology, that is crater. Crater is nothing but the mouth of the volcano. Vent is the pipe like structure through which the magma comes out on the earth's surface. And volcanic cone is the shape of the volcano. And lava flow is the flow of the lava. Volcanic cloud, which contain the pyroclastic material, solid material, liquid and gaseous material, and the magma chamber, which is present below the earth surface in the asthenosphere. So we have discussed the terminology. Now there are classification of the magma. So on the basis of the mode of eruption, the classification is divided into 5 type of volcano, that is Hawaiian type volcano, Pelean type of volcano, Strombolian type of volcano, Vesuvius type of volcano, and Vulcanian type of volcano. And the fissure type of volcano, on the basis of, there are two type, that is lava flood or the flow of lava and the mud flow. And if we talking about the periodicity of the volcano, so there are three basic type of volcano, that is active volcano, dormant volcano, and extinct volcano. Active volcano is the volcano which erupt throughly year by year. And if we're talking about the dormant volcano, so the eruption after a long interval of time. And if we're talking about the extinct volcano, it gives the activity since a very long time in the geological history. So this is extinct volcano. Then volcanic type, there are three basic volcanic type, that is in shield volcano, composite volcano, strato volcano, and the lava dome. So on the basis of the formation of the lava and the spreading pattern of the lava, there are three basic type of volcano: strato volcano, shield volcano, and lava dome. And if we talking about the volcanic materials, there are three basic type of volcanic material, that is solid material, gaseous material, and liquid material. Solid material, which contain pyroclastic material, gaseous material, which contain most of the carbon dioxide, water vapor, which contain 70%, nitrogen contain 5%, and the liquid material contain the molten magma rock fragments. And then we have discussed about the surface lava flow. There are three basic type of surface lava flow, that is blocky lava flow, ropey lava flow, and pillow lava flow. So the blocky lava is highly viscous because of the silica percentage in it, and their movement is very slow, so and gives a blocky like structure or a rough surface structure. And if you talking about the ropey lava flow, so ropey lava flow is in the smooth but twisted surface. So on the basis of these, it gives a name ropey lava. It is basaltic in composition, and it has a less silica percentage. And if you talking about the pillow lava, so pillow lava is basaltic composition which flows over sea floor. It solidified with surface and with gives a pillow like structure. So, and then we have seen the phenomena associated with the volcanism. The what are the phenomena? That is spring, fumaroles, and geysers. The hot spring are the commonly found associated with the volcanic activity, and fumaroles include the steam or hot gases, and discharge the fumaroles and gives sulfur dioxide or sulfur, and the heat of these fumaroles is native sulfur. And if you're talking about the geysers are the fountain of hot water, and these geysers often rise to height of 30 to 60 meters, and the deposition of these geyser done by is geyserite. So this all about the volcano, and we have completed 5th lecture. Till date we have completed 5th lecture, and if you have any question or doubt regarding the lectures, topic or the unit, you can ask in the comment section and mention your name or roll number in the comment section. So be safe, stay at home and be safe, and have a nice day. So thank you. And this is also a book reference. You can read it or make your notes from it. So thank you. Stay safe, stay healthy. Bye.